Why do your aquarium plants keep dying, even though you're doing everything right? It's not your fault. There's a critical piece of information no one tells you about, and that's why exactly what we're diving into today. If you ever struggled with yellowing leaves, melting stems, or plants that just won't thrive, stick around, you're about to find out what's really going wrong, and more importantly, how to fix it. You've spent hours setting up your dream aquascape. The substrate is perfect. The lighting looks something out of a magazine, and you've carefully selected beautiful, lush plants. Fast forward a few weeks, and those vibrant greens are now dull, yellow, or even worse, decaying into a mush. Sound familiar? You're not alone. Today, we're uncovering the hidden reasons behind dying aquarium plants and giving you actionable steps to turn those things around. Whether you're a beginner or a seasoned aquascaper, this is the video that's going to save your plants and your sanity. Let's be real. There's nothing more frustrating than seeing your beautiful aquarium plants slowly deteriorate. The leaves start yellowing, the growth stops, and before you know it, you're left with a tank that looks more like a graveyard than a lush underwater paradise. Am I right? But here's the kicker. The problem isn't always obvious. Sure, you've checked the basics, right? Light, CO2, and nutrients, but something still isn't right. So, what's going on? Lighting is the lifeblood of your plants. But here's the thing, not all lights are created equal. Maybe you've got a fancy LED setup, but is it providing the right spectrum and intensity? Plus, plants need specific wavelengths to photosynthesize effectively. Too much light can cause algae to take over, while too little light leaves your plants starving. Check your light's PAR levels and adjust the phototype period to about 6 to 8 hours a day. If you're not sure about your setup, upgrading to a light designed specifically for aquarium plants can make a world of difference. CO2 is another major factor if you use it, and many aquarists underestimate how crucial it is. Without enough CO2, even the hardest plants can struggle. If you're noticing slow growth or melting leaves, this could be your issue. Investing in a CO2 injection system can dramatically improve plant health. And if CO2 system isn't in your budget, consider low-tech plants like Java fern or anubias that don't require as much. Hey, yellowing leaves, that's a classic sign of nutrient deficiency. Aquarium plants need a balanced diet of macro and micronutrients. Nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, NPK, are the big players. But don't forget about trace elements like iron, magnesium, and manganese. If you're not dosing fertilizers, your plants are probably starving. Liquid fertilizers and root tabs can help, but make sure you're not overdoing it. Too many nutrients can cause algae blooms. Your substrate isn't just there to look pretty, it's a vital component of your plant's ecosystem. If you're using plain gravel or sand, your plants might not be getting the nutrients they actually need. Hey, switching to a nutrient-rich substrate or even adding root tabs can make a huge difference, especially for root-feeding plants like Amazon swords or even cryptocorns. So now let's talk of water. The wrong pH, hardness, or even temperature can wreak havoc on your plants. For most aquarium plants, a pH between 6.0 and 7.5 and a temperature of 72 to 82 works best. Use a reliable test kit to monitor the parameters and make adjustments as you may need. Remember, consistency is key. Sudden changes in water chemistry can shock your plants and lead to die-off, just like fish. If algae is taking over, it's not just an eyesore, it's actively competing with your plant for light and nutrients. So to combat algae, ensure you're not overfeeding your fish and maintain a proper lighting schedule, and consider adding algae-eating fish or shrimp. Siamese algae eaters and a mono shrimp are excellent choices. So believe it or not, how you plant your aquarium flora really matters. Burying the crown of rosette plants or planting stem plants too deep can actually cause them to rot. Always research the specific planting requirements for your plants and follow them carefully. So here's the bottom line. If your plants are dying, it's a clear sign that something in your tank's ecosystem is out of balance. So the good news, every single issue we've covered today has a solution. So by fine-tuning your lighting, CO2, and nutrients and water parameters, you're not just saving your plants, you're creating a thriving underwater world. So imagine looking at your tank a month from now and seeing lush, vibrant growth instead of decay. So that's what's waiting for you if you take action today. So your aquarium plants don't have to keep dying. By addressing lighting, CO2, and nutrients, and substrate, and water, you can transform your tank into a lush, thriving ecosystem. So remember, aquascaping is a journey, and even small changes can make a huge difference. So start with one adjustment at a time and watch your tank come to life. Hey, subscribe for more tips or watch this next video to master aquarium fertilizers. And I will see you there.